James Dickson, Jerry Merrill.
And you guys are from?
Hendersonville, North Carolina.
And tell us a little bit about what's behind you.
Well, here we have the cutaway tractor. International had produced either 9 or 13 of them. We don't know all of the story or the details. This was a tractor we had seen in a show down in Florida. This is a replica. It's not one of the originals. So being interested in international production and education, we decided we might try to build one of these tractors ourselves.
Yeah.
So about 27 holes later, 500 hours of manpower, this is the end result. So our chief engineer, designer, wire man is here with us, and I'll let James tell you a little about some of the interesting things we had to do to this tractor.
Okay.
We cut the holes in it so that we could show the workings of each segment of it. We then cleaned it up, painted it with automotive paint so it'd be pretty, and then we made sure that we could oil it and make it run. Then we wired it so that it will make it run at a 20 RPM and the spark plugs spark when they're supposed to, and there's little lights that show in the cavities where you can see it running.
And it's color-coded and stuff, right, as an educational tool?
It is color-coded to show water, the intake and the exhaust is all color-coded so you can see the changes.
And you have taken this around and used it as an educational tool. Where all have you?
We have taken it to several schools. We like to go to middle schools, but the grammar school kids really enjoy it too. We have learned that there's a lot of interest in it, especially the mechanical part of it, even for kids. And we have taken it to schools, and we have gone into Georgia, Tennessee, and now we're in Ohio, so it's spreading out, and we're beginning to have people enjoy it for what we are.
Nice. And what do you find are some of the comments that people make when they're looking at it and viewing it, besides from, wow, that's really cool? What do you think are some main takeaways that people get from this?
Wow, it's cool. Some of the things that made this tractor very popular was it was a tractor that was designed about 1946, probably came online in 47. It's the little tractor that wouldn't stop selling. Produced probably over 200,000. And the other thing that made this popular tractor very popular was it was the right tractor at the right time, at the right place, in the right hands of the people who needed this to help farm. Now, IH had done their research, knowing that after the war there was a tremendous amount of horses and mules still on the farm, probably 10 or 12 million. And they discovered that the farms in the south and the east probably were only 12 or 15 acres. So they began to set forth a product that would replace that horse and mule. Knowing that horse and man may plow a couple of acres a day, this tractor may increase that production by 50%. Not only was that an important role, but that horse and mule would have to be fed 3 times a day, and that horse and mule would eat 1/3 of what that farmer was trying to produce. So therefore, if you had a crop failure, disease, fire, bugs, disease, then you may be a little hungry that night. Having given the fact that that horse and mule had to be fed 3 times a day, again, the right time, the right place, the right tractor, put the tractor in the barn, shut the door, enjoy your family dinner that night.
And part of the right time had to do with what was going on historically in the world with the ending of the war, right?
This is very true.
Right.
And what probably happened there was that Johnny came home from the Navy, and Pop said, "Son, let's get out the horse and mule." And probably Johnny said, "Dad, I've marched all over Europe. I've carried those guns. There's a better ideal." This tractor probably sold for 400 $450 bucks, maybe $550, depending on the dealership. And so this is where the concept of the little red tractor that would not start selling continued to grow in importance. And it was, again, the right tractor at the right time in the right hands for the people.
And just to be clear, the model is, what model exactly is it? It's the Farmall.
It's a Farmall Cub 1951 model.
Which is, this is the 75th anniversary of that tractor, right?
I think that's right.
Yes, I think you're
of the Cub.
Yes.
Of the Cub.
Cub, yeah.
Yeah.
The Cub
great.
Only had a little over 9 horsepower.
Uh-huh.
And with lots of equipment could be brought with it, so things could be done to it that you couldn't do with a horse anyway. It could plow and plant and harvest too. So it became very usable and cost efficient. It was only burned less than a gallon of fuel in an hour. So that was not costly to like a horse was. So it was a very efficient thing. And these little cubs were very dependent. They would run forever under the right hands.
And many of them still are, as I've been seeing throughout the fair. There's cubs everywhere.
Many of them still are, yes.
Yeah. But yours is very unique. And also, this is original signage, right, from the cub, the actual teddy bear cub, right?
From the original.
That you have. Tell me a little bit about that. That was the original banner marketing?
It was the original banner marketing. We have a larger sign here that see also.
Nice.
And this particular sign just spells out all of the important features of this tractor. And it's designated as to the drive gears, the transmission, the clutches, the crankshaft, the cooling system. And all of this, again, was very important because how do you cool a mule? It's through water, percolation. And bearings, governors. A mule has a gate, a tractor's got a governor gate. So you can see why all this is very important. Steering, which was equally as important.
Do you know the history of this?
No.
I do not know the history of this. But notice the bear has only one shoe on. Notice the nose is an owl.
Is an owl. This looks like feathers up here, and it also has a designated tongue. I don't know the history of that.
Okay, well, that's something we're going to have to find out for another video.
It's odd.
Interesting.
Notice
yeah.
The gallus is yellow here, the hook, and the other one is clear.
Hmm.
Notice the bear's pointing to the Farmall Cub sign. Makes sense. Cub bear, cub tractor.
Yes.
Very good coordination with somebody's demeanor. So.
Well, thank you so much, gentlemen. I really appreciate you sharing all of this wonderful information.
Thank you for the opportunity to share, to educate, promote, and continue to be a part of this educational system